Welcome back, Amy Emmeleth, along with a little chinchilla, a little soft little creature from the Maryland Zoo, joining us now, right down the hill here at Druid Hill Park. What a beauty.
She is. She knows it, too. Her name is Snow Queen. She's one of our animal ambassadors, one of our cold weather hardy animal ambassadors.
Talk about soft.
I know.
Wow.
I tell people it's like air with a rat inside. So they're little tiny rodents.
It is a rodent.
They're
it
from
also sheds.
Very,
yes.
Very full of fur, and yes. It comes off at the blink of an eye. But they have super, super fine fur, which is why people made coats out of them. But when you think of that, that little face is making a coat. 250 of them it takes. So
to make a coat.
They're almost extinct in the wild for that reason. Mm-hmm.
So, and you were telling me they don't know how to survive in the wild
they
anymore.
They don't.
Because so many are captive, raised for farming purposes.
Exactly. And for the pet trade. And with the chinchilla, you know, they're rodents, so you think they're pretty resilient, but they really haven't had any successful reintroduction programs. So they haven't been able to put them back out into the wild. They really just, they're just very pretty. Very pretty. They don't really know how to survive out in the wild.
And they are soft.
And this is why this is a great animal ambassador. It's one that we can talk about how they're continually trying to figure out a way to get them back out into the wild.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. Speaking of the wild, all your wild creatures at the zoo. You told me you had a birthday coming up. Not you.
Not I mean, me, yes.
Not
till June.
One of the residents.
We do. One of our polar bears, Anoki, is having her 16th birthday, mm-hmm. and that is on Tuesday, and the keepers are putting together a polar bear birthday cake for her. Not made of polar bears, made for polar bears.
Okay.
I'm sure it'll have lots of lard and fun stuff like that on it, and they're going to do that around 11:30 on Tuesday, so if you have the day off or are home this week with your kids, please come out and see us. We have events every day.
Was Anoki born there? Or brought in?
She wasn't born in there. She was brought in for part of the breeding mm-hmm. program. So every year we do try to breed the polar bears. They're recommended, but we no babies this year, so we're going to throw our big party instead.
Anoki likes the cold. You have other animals there that can take the cold quite naturally.
They can. A lot of our African animals, which people don't realize, can take the cold. Our elephants, if it's above 40 and sunny, they're outside. Same with the rhinos, because they're acclimated to it. They've been here a long time, and they're very used to the winters.
So there's something to see. The exhibits are active during
That's right. Yeah. Every day we have something to see. If you check the website, marylandzoo.org, you can find there are creature encounters every day. So you can have you can talk to the keepers about what they do, what the training programs they have. So I know we do otters and penguins and elephants and rhinos. So there's lots of things to learn every single day at the zoo.
Which reminds us, because it's something you go to all the time, a great birthday gift would be, what, season passes and whatnot?
Exactly. Yeah. You can buy those online. You can buy tickets year-round. You can also a great gift for the family over the holidays. Is a membership.
Yeah.
So you can give the membership, and I talk to a lot of people who get that every year for their kids or their grandkids, and they can come throughout the year for that. And you get discounts on tickets to events throughout the year if you're a member.
Okay. Amy, thanks for joining us talking about the Maryland Zoo in Baltimore and it's air. You're right. It's all air.
I know. Yeah. They're so soft.
Okay. Have a nice time enjoying your captive existence, and we'll be back with